Welcome to the series of videos about functional programming in Kotlin with Arrow. Arrow is a library packed with data types and type classes, bringing functional programming to Kotlin. In this video, we are going to learn about SetK data type and what it's used for. SetK is a data type belonging to the wrappers category. These types wrap over some of Kotlin's collections and functions to give them capabilities that are related to the type classes provided by Arrow. A SetK can be initialized through a classic constructor, which expects a set collection. There is also a convenient K function available that can be called over the set interface. Or you can get a SetK by invoking the setkJust method. This method expects only one parameter and will return a setK of just one element. The type classes available for a setK are semigroup, semigroup K, monoid, monoid K, and foldable. Unlike other wrappers like listK or sequenceK, setK doesn't derive functor, applicative, monad, or traverse. This is due to the lack of ordering guarantees on a set data structure. A semigroup is a set A with an associative operation, which we will be calling combine. Here, we are combining two sets, which in our case is performed as a concatenation of the content on each structure. We can define monoids as combinable objects that have an empty value, which functions as an identity. In our code snippet, we can check that by calling the empty method, we will receive a setK with no inner values. And then, when combining it with a setK, the same setK will be returned. Semigroup K and monoid K are special cases. They are universal type classes which operate on kinds, which is what the K in their names stands for. The subtle difference between semigroup and semigroup K, monoid and monoid K, is that while semigroup and monoid operate on the values contained in the type constructor, semigroup K and monoid K operate exclusively over the entire structure and not individual items. We will take an in-depth look at those in future videos, as they have enough content on their own. A foldable has a structure from which a value can be computed from visiting each element. We can fold over set, transforming the values contained to produce a single result. In this case, we have two arguments. The first parameter is the initial value, and the second is a function for transforming the value in each iteration. In this example, we are accumulating a power of each number contained in our set. In addition, foldable type classes offer another method called foldRight. As the name implies, foldRight starts folding from the right side and processes the values in a right-to-left order. Here again, we are accumulating a power of each number of a set. But you can see some differences in its use. The reason for this is because, in contrast with foldLeft, which operates in an eager way, foldRight will evaluate the past function lazily, only performing the computation when we call the value method. This allows us to support laziness in a stack-safe way. In Arrow, for this kind of lazy computed values, eval can be used. For more information on this data type, you can check out eval video in this series. In this video, we learn about SetK. As part of Arrow's unified programming model, SetK shares a lot of the functions and different functionality with other higher-candid wrappers. We will learn more about those in next videos. Thanks for watching.